shippers. Is that a thing that we're using? No? Okay, well, hi guys. Oh my god, Marina's consistently making a video again. What is this? It's craziness. I know. It's hard to handle, but we'll get through it. Everything is gonna be okay. So my week has been quite fantastic. As Jason mentioned, on Saturday, we all met up and had good times, and none of us died. There was no kidnapping or rape or murder or any of that stuff involved. So that was a cool thing. Also, I vote for a road trip, all of us, to go kidnap Kayla over in Canada, because I've never been to Canada, and that just seems like, you know, a logical plan of action. Okay, so now to our theme of the week, which is favorite characters, and I know that there was supposed to be like a 5-character limit, but I'm probably going to exceed that just because I love all the characters. Anyway, so, favorite character of all time, probably not a surprise if you followed me on Tumblr back like a year ago when Deathly Hallows Part 2 was released. Severus Snape is my favorite character. He's so great. I love Severus Snape. Just such a complex character and just best character. I'm sorry. He's my favorite. I love him. And if you don't like Severus Snape, then I'm sorry, but I have a problem with you because he is just so fantastic and okay, this is not going to be an intelligent video. This is just going to be me fangirling over all of the characters. I hope that's okay. Another character that I really, really loved just pretty much immediately when I started reading To Kill a Mockingbird was Boo Radley, because he was so mysterious and you didn't know what was his deal. At the beginning, the kids are all like, oh my god, he's terrifying, and they would tell like scary stories about him and do like plays of him like stabbing people with scissors. And I don't want to spoil any of you guys. I mean, I think most people have read the book, but yeah, the end just gives you a lot of feels and it just makes you happy, and it's so, Boo Radley, I love you. Okay, as you guys probably know, if you've seen my obsessive Avatar live blogging posts on Tumblr, I started watching Avatar and I finished it within like a week. So two of the characters on this list are actually from Avatar. So I was gonna say Toph, but Jason already talked about Toph and stole my favorite character, but you know, it's cool, whatever. Yeah, so I'm not really gonna talk about just how great she is, because if you've seen the show, then you know, she's just fucking awesome. For some reason, I really, really love Sokka. I just think he's so funny and great. Like, some of my favorite moments in the show have just been him being ridiculous, and I really like kind of the lighthearted humor that he adds to the show. I definitely don't think it would be the same without him. And he's not just like a one-sided character, because, you know, he does struggle with trying to be a man and all that, and like trying to live up to like his father. I like him. I like Sokka a lot. So the next character is either going to be really surprising or not surprising at all, just considering how much I kind of talk about this character and how some cool things have happened in my life because of this character, basically. This character is Holden Caulfield, and I have a huge love-hate relationship with Holden. He's just that obnoxious little prick that you just kind of hate, but then deep down you know that he's part of you, like he's just that part of yourself that you're not supposed to like but always exists. Like, he's pretty much just angst personified into a character. Crap. Okay, last one really quick is Zuko, and it's pretty much for that same reason. He is so fucking angsty, but he's also really good deep down, and I just kind of love making fun of him. So yeah, Zuko and Holden, kind of, I like making fun of them. Anyway, my camera's gonna shut off.